What are the Pythagorean and just intonation systems? And how does a string player decide which to prioritize at any given moment? I am fortunate to be playing on an instrument that doesn't have to be tempered or a set system which the performer has no control over. String players, vocalists, and wind players to a certain extent are able to adjust their intonation in real time to be as in tune with their ensemble as they can. However, playing in tune can be complicated and it can create a paradox, especially when you consider the linear intonation of a melody and the vertical intonation of a harmony. Hey, this is Ina Langerman from Violina.live, and in this video I will give a brief overview of two tuning systems that string players and actually all musicians should have a basic understanding of. I'm just going to give you a summary, and of course there have been many other tuning systems over the course of history, many of which are still being used today. So if you wish to dive deeper into this rabbit hole, I strongly recommend check out this book called How Equal Temperament Ruined Harmony and Why You Should Care. I'm going to leave my affiliate link to this book in the description below in case you're interested to learning this all in more detail. The Pythagorean system is based on the perfect fifths interval tuned to the ratio of 3 to 2, which gives it its pure quality. So to get the 3 to 2 ratio, all you have to do is take the hertz of the starting note and multiply it by 1.5. So for example, if we take A440 and we want to get the perfect fifth above it in its purest form, we multiply 440 by 1.5 and we get 660 hertz, the E above. Now compare this to a piano tuned to equal temperament at 440. That same E will be ever so slightly lower. It's going to be probably around 659 hertz or maybe between 659 and 660. It's a very small difference, and that's because in equal temperament we divide all of the half steps evenly. So those fifths, they get compromised ever so slightly. So the Pythagorean system follows around the circle of fifths, creating that 3-to-2 ratio over and over and over again. And a great example of this are the stringed instruments themselves. You know, we normally tune them to perfect fifths and in its purest forms as we possibly can. And double bassists tune to perfect fourths, and that's the inversion of perfect fifths, so they fall into this category as well. The Pythagorean system is most frequently used to play single-line melodic material that are based on scales. Staggering notes in this ratio result in a wide major third interval, which is actually helpful for melodies because it supports the idea of expressive intonation in which leading tones lead up to the resolution, or other neighbor tones they resolve by creating a small half step. This allows melodies to sound the most in tune to the human ear. However, there are two problems with the Pythagorean system. The large major third interval, while it helps us to hear that linear melody in tune, if that third is placed as part of a chord, that chord on its own, it's going to sound out of tune. If it's played as a double stop, for example, that third interval, it would have to be placed a little bit lower to create a pure major third interval and make the chord resonate in tune. The second problem has to do with the overall intonation. So let's see what happens if we continue staggering perfect fifths on top of each other beyond the four open strings. If we start with the note C, for example, and go all the way around the circle of fifths, by the time we return back to the note C, it actually won't be in tune with the note that we started with. It's actually going to be significantly sharper. Before we continue, if you're getting any value from this video so far, please give it a quick thumbs up down below. Now let's take a look at just intonation. This system is based on the harmonic series of a given fundamental pitch, creating all pure intervals. So the harmonic series, for those who don't know, it's a sequence of notes where each frequency is a multiple of the starting note, whatever that note might be. So for example, we can use one of the open strings as our fundamental note. This system is used primarily to tune chords. This is very helpful in an ensemble like the string quartet or while playing double stops. Of course, while those ratios remain the same, just intonation system changes a little bit depending on that fundamental note. So the frequencies don't necessarily translate the same way across all the keys. While this system keeps those thirds and sixths in their pure form and really helps those chords resonate and be really in tune vertically, Unfortunately, that makes the horizontal melody out of tune. And herein lies the paradox of intonation. Performing any solo repertoire that combines double stops with melodic material, like solo Bach or Isaiah sonatas, for example, we run into this conflict quite a bit, and we need to make compromises. What do we prioritize and why? This is also why tuning string quartets can be such a daunting process. Wait, did you say your string quartet just turned into a piano quintet? Well, now in addition to everything else, you will probably have to compromise for equal temperament once in a while in order to be in tune with the piano. In the next video, we're going to explore some examples from the violin standard repertory, and we're going to look at the interplay between just intonation and Pythagorean systems. Sometimes the two are going to clash, and we can discuss what would be a decent compromise in specific situations and why. Alright, so thank you so much for watching this video, and if you found this useful, please share it with a friend or a colleague. If you would like to have more content like this, both in video and written form, and you want to hold discussions on this on a deeper level and other topics as well, sign up for my bi-monthly newsletter in the description below, and also don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell. I upload every Friday at 11 a.m. Eastern. Happy practicing and happy June! See you next time!